this opportunity of a lifetime. It means absolutely nothing if you don't take advantage of it in the lifetime of this opportunity.
I got a saying that when life knocks you down, try and land on your back, because if you can look up, you can get up. If you want a thing bad enough to go out and fight for, to work day and night for, to give up your time, your peace, and your sleep for, if all that you dream and scheme is about it, and life seems useless and worthless without it. See, it's time now. If you want to make this your decade, you've got to start saying yes to your life. You've got to start saying yes to your dreams. Yes to your unfolding future. Yes to your potential. As opposed to saying no.
When you die, die on E. Leave no dream left behind, guys. Leave no opportunity left behind. When you leave this earth, accomplish every single thing you can accomplish. Listen to me, you're gonna be here one day, but you'll never get here if you give up, if you give in, if you quit. And finally, guys, you gotta wanna succeed as bad as you wanna breathe.
Motion fakes, he keeps the football. Again over the left side, he's being pursued, but bust to the outside. He's to the 15, to the 10, he's to the 5. Shoemaker into the end zone for the Red Bank Valley touchdown. That goes 25 yards. Takes the snap, rolls to the right side. He's looking, dumps that into the end zone. It's caught! Touchdown! To the right, looks to throw, does. It's caught by Hetrick. And Hetrick busts it!
First of all, I want to thank a couple of people real quick. Let's get a round of applause for the cheerleaders. Secondly, let's get a round of applause for the band for playing for us. And playing for us. Next, I want to thank the AV Club for putting all this stuff together. You can see we went above and beyond. That's thanks to them. And finally, I want to thank Mr. Greg Knoll and his team and Broadcast Club for putting together that pretty sweet video. Let's hear it for Greg. Real quickly, before I get to these knuckleheads here, I want to acknowledge some other fall sports that have done some pretty special things this year. If you are a boys soccer player, please stand up. Stand up. These boys soccer players, obviously, probably not where they wanted to finish at, but so tremendously cool that you had some basketball guys willing to play that way they could have a team. We need that in a small school. None of this specializing stuff. We need guys playing multiple sports. So let's hear it for our soccer team for having a team. Also, for the boys soccer team, want to congratulate Aaron Smith and Dalton Dougherty for being all-conference selections. Dalton Dougherty, for the first time ever playing soccer. How cool is that for the nation? Secondly, ladies volleyball, stand up. Volleyball, stand up. Ladies volleyball, doing their thing like always, right? We know where they're always there at the top. So they're going in. They've got a playoff game Tuesday night against North Clarion. They're the number 3 seed. They finished 14-2, and I'm excited because they beat North Clarion, then they get to beat Clarion. How about that? Yeah. Congratulations to our girls volleyball team. Finally, girls soccer, stand up. Our girls soccer team this year is 16-3 right now. They just beat Port Allegheny 1-0 in the first round of the playoffs. And it was also just announced that they get the opportunity to beat Carm City on Tuesday at Clarion University at 8 o'clock. Let's hear it for our girls soccer team. Also want to congratulate Zoe Stewart, Alexa Smith, Sam Landers for being all-conference selections for soccer. Let's hear it for them. And finally, the soccer team has this girl by the name of Jasmine Adams. Does anybody know her? Is anybody in here a fan of Jasmine Adams? Jasmine Adams completely obliterated her sister's goal scored record. Her sister scored 22 goals last year. Jasmine only scored 41. Jasmine Adams, who was also just released last week, that she was named the MVP of the conference. Let's hear it for Jasmine. Give me a second, I'll be right back. Adversity. Have we heard that term before? Adversity is any sort of difficulty or struggle that comes up. One of my favorite quotes ever is adversity will either kill you, it will allow you to succeed, but it will always reveal you. It will always show what type of person you are. Are you the type of person that when adversity comes, you roll over, you quit, you say life's too hard, boo-hoo, I'm done? Are you the type of person that looks adversity right in the eyes and you say, let's go. I'm going to learn from my failure. I'm going to learn from my mistakes. And I'm going to take this adversity. I'm going to take your adversity. I'm going to shove it somewhere. Those are the two types of people that you have. And the reason that I bring up that term is because I look at that we know right here, we've got a very special senior class. We have spent the last couple weeks as a football team talking about how special our 11 seniors are. And when I look at the two senior classes of Clarion football, and I look at the two senior classes of Red Bank football, I see two classes that have dealt with adversity very, very differently. Okay? To illustrate here, see how you guys react to this. How's this look right here? Clarion seniors in 4 years have been 41-7 in play in 4 years. They have been 18-1 in the KSAC. Until this year, those seniors had never lost a conference football game. They've gone to two D9 title games, winning one of them, going to state playoffs, and unfortunately, they are 4-0 against Red Bank Valley. When I look at that, I see that Clarion hasn't dealt with much adversity. I see that for them, it has been win, 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 win. And that's not how life works. Life doesn't work out well if it's win, 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 win all the time. You've got to face a struggle. You've got to go through hard times. Sometimes you've got to get knocked on your can so you can learn how to get back up. And in my opinion, the reason that Clarion has lost two games this year is because for the first time in their life, those seniors have had to deal with adversity and they don't know how to handle it. Okay? If I were to, I'm not going to because it's going to make a big mess. But if I were to take this hammer, saying it's adversity, and take it against this glass, what would happen? It would break. It would shatter. Okay? I'll come back to Clarion in a second. On the other hand, our seniors, they have faced a good amount of adversity. As freshmen, what were you?
1-8.
Wow! 1-8 as freshmen, and they came back. Some kids quit, some kids gave it up. But these 10, we've got 11 now, but 10 kids kept coming back every single year. Their sophomore year, they started to turn it up a little bit. The adversity they faced, playing two games against Clarion, he now scored 105-0. That puts things in perspective for you, doesn't it? And you've got a choice. They had a choice to quit. They had a choice to say, you know what, we will never defeat that team. We will never have a chance against them. Or they said to themselves, we can work harder. We can come back. And they fought their way back. They went to the playoffs and they fell to Clarion and did the championship game. An incredible year. Their junior year, those kids who were sophomores turned into men. They turned it up. They contributed more. They had their chance against Clarion. They came up just short. Did that fuel you guys this offseason? Do you still think about that game every single time you step on the practice field? Again, they took the failure and they learned from it and it molded them. A couple weeks later, we got upset in the first round of playoffs. Did that motivate you? Did it fuel you? Did it make you the team you are today? Now, I've got glass for Clarion. On the other hand, I'm going to hold the mic upside down. Our guys, in my opinion, we've lost. We've won a lot of football games. We've won 22 with these seniors, but we've also lost 17. But in those losses, we've been forged. We've got a group of seniors that are made of steel right now. We got a group of seniors I would put up against anybody because they've tasted the failure and they've come back and they've gotten even better. And you know what happens when adversity hits someone that's forged in steel? 1-8 is freshmen. Losing to Camp Clarion twice as sophomores. Barely losing to Clarion in the regular season as juniors. Getting upset in the first round of the playoffs. Not coming out well against Kerwinsville this year. We are where we are because they have reacted to adversity and they have become better people. What happens when steel meets glass? Does anybody know what happens when steel meets glass? Clarion seniors right here. How do you like that? Tonight is our night. It's our opportunity. We haven't taken down these guys for a long time. It's our chance. Now, I talked to some of the seniors, and last time I was here for a pep rally, I did a little bird chant. They said they liked it. Can you do that with me again? Yeah. Repeat after me. We're going to do it three times, and I want it to get louder every single time. A little orange bird.
Little orange bird.
From Clarion.
From Clarion.
Landed upon.
Landed upon.
windowsill.
My windowsill.
I lured him in. With a piece of bread. And then I crushed. His freaking head. A little orange bird. Glaring. Landed upon. My windowsill.
I lured him in.
With a piece of bread. And then I crushed. His freaking head.
Three.
One, two, three.
Be clear.
One, two, three.
Be clear.